but it appears I've still got a lot to learn.
I haven't even gotten to the damn ruins yet, and already I'm getting my shit wrecked. Well, this is just peachy. They never said this game would be easy. Oh look, a door that fuck-ass can do and get hurt while doing. Oh, what? No dungeon? You just get it? Fuck that. What is this thing? Auto shield. Yeah. Maybe it can only be equipped by him. Yeah. Yep. For now. Relax and crisis. Magic no.
Holy head scratcher. The Riddler's got us completely bamboozled.
Why? What did the Riddler do this time?
He fucked us. With a wooden gun.
He fucked us with a wooden gun. Okay, so the last time I was watching you play was a while ago.
I got to disc 4.
So last time I saw you play, Kaim and Sarah were still in an unknown status.
They were trapped in ice, and I had to rescue them with magic users fighting against a guy with reflect, auto-reflect. It was just a long fight. It wasn't particularly hard.
And then, Jansen, Ming, and the kids had just met up and fought a thing.
Okay, well, they fought another giant, dude, like a very tall, spindly dude with reflect on.
Mm.
That was the last thing before everybody was reunited.
And then, Seth and the king had just made it to find Sed.
Yep. Then they escaped the city in the ship.
Okay.
That I have. So then everyone met up and the Disc Four started.
Out of my way.
Somehow, Seth, Tolton, and Sed found their way to the same place where the other people were, and they had just freed Kaim and Sarah. And then that's how they all met up.
But basically nothing else has happened other than all of them getting back together.
Yep. Nothing huge. Oh, I guess, like, Golgara, like... No, Gungar didn't really do anything. He just drank blood and became the ruler of Ura.
Uh-huh.
But that was really all he did. You guys have a lot of HP. We got a water beast, who is obviously water and beast. Water beast! What are his types? And then this guy is wind, and this guy is spirit magic none. Huh. Earth beats water, so...
No!
What did you do?
I tried to talk in the chat.
Well, get rid of that window. We just read the chat.
But...
Do I not have Earth level 2 anything? I do. I have one of them.
But...
Mount Your Friends is currently the fourth most popular game on Twitch.
Mount? Why would I do that?
I have that game.
Good.
I've yet to play it, but it was like $2. Well, apparently someone popular is doing it, so there's now like 22,000 people watching him.
Hasn't that game been around for a while?
It came out on PC sometime last year. But it was around for a while as an Xbox indie game that came out after we hit our streams. And it was like the one that everyone was like, oh yeah, this is awesome. Because it's like Quap, but you're basically a dude in a Speedo with dong physics.
Yeah.
And then you have, like, other people and, like, goats and stuff, and you try to clock your way to, like, as high as possible. And there's, like, there's different modes, too, where some of them are multiplayer. I wanted to play it, but you need to, like, get some people to do it.
Yeah, TK Cat points out that the blood texture they used for Gongara drinking the blood was terrible. Like, hilariously terrible.
Please take my head out of this bucket of ice. There we go.
Purgatory Ore and Round Spirit Stone. Wonder what those do. Volcano Ring. Fire level 3. Hey. I need more Purgatory Ore. Typhoon and Water
critical
Level.
Critical fire damage. There's damage, severe damage, and critical damage.
I don't think it means like critical, like a critical hit. No. I think it's just like a lot of damage. I can make one of these. Yeah.
Significant, massive.
I'm gonna have a spirit killer.
I just have to make one.
So it goes straight from spirit ring to spirit ring 3. Okay, maybe, enchanted ring. Which it's not in between these two where it should be. Yeah. Weird.
It is not TB Taco, it's TB Chicken Biscuit. It is a chicken biscuit taco. Although it would be somewhat insane to have the entire Taco Bell menu available as Twitch emotes.
Yeah, I don't know.
That'd be awesome. Then you could just talk to each other entirely in orders.
I suppose.
You'd be like, I need... This is how I'm feeling right now. Grilled stuffed with steak... Cheesy Fiesta Potatoes, and a Baja Blast. And you'd be able to share that emotion with the world. The manual overload. Taco Bell chicken cheese.
I had an andouille sausage today.
The thing about chicken cheese is almost any time you'd want a chicken cheese, why not just make a cheesesteak or get a cheesesteak?
Isn't that just a chicken cheese, like a different name for a chicken cheesesteak?
Yes. Notably there's no steak. It's to avoid calling it a chicken cheesesteak because...
What's wrong with calling it a chicken cheese steak?
But there's no fucking steak in a chicken cheese steak. That's why it's a chicken cheese.
But what if you want chicken and not steak?
Then you order a chicken cheese, and you don't order a cheese steak.
Right, but you're saying why not just order... You're saying why not just order a cheese steak, and I'm saying,
right.
Well, what if I don't want a cheese steak? What if I want chicken cheese?
You don't. You always want a cheese steak.
I don't.
There's never a situation in which you're like, man, I really need this, like, gut buster, but I wish it had chicken. Maybe if it was fried.
Maybe if you're Indian.
What if you had the fried chicken cheese?
Oh, okay.
I think then it could work. I think you could be willing to crave a fried chicken cheese over a cheesesteak.
I don't think anyone's ever made one of those before.
I know, it sounds really good.
So this is some bullshit.
It can't be that hard. You just make it with, like, chicken tenders or whatever.
Oh, what the fuck? I wanted to go up, not down.
Get the, You go to Popeye's and you order their chicken fingers. Their chicken fingers are pretty good.
Please say I have time with me.
Oh, come on. Give me a break.
Nope. Aha. And guess who they replaced him with? Tolton, of all people. Great.
They're fighting Twin Rosa.
At least it gives me some options.
If you wanted to have a lighter chicken meal, you would not get it covered in fucking fuck-ass cheese served on a big fucking loaf of bread.
It's true.
You'd be like, I would like my chicken grilled with a salad and some salsa.
Where's my Earth level 2?
Probably attached to Kine.
Fuck-ass. Alright. This'll do, I guess. What is equipped on you? Hacker ring. Great.
I guess give him beast crap.
Are they, I have a beast level 2 anywhere?
You can do water level 2 on,
Yeah, but I want to concentrate on one guy at a time. Mm. I'll do one of these ones that has beast and a million other things. That doesn't do anything for me, whatever. What do you even put? Earth. Hey, there
hey, that's Earth level 2.
There it is.
So his physical normal attack is that he shoots his gun.
Yep.
That's awesome.
And quite a good gun it is.
Oh yeah, he's got like no MP. Managed to own the fire guy hard enough that he got blown back into taking his turn.
I didn't notice that. Now he's blown into the next turn.
Huh. Weird.
Well, that'll just happen when you hit them. Like, everything has a static delay effect. Ooh, that'll do. Biokiller organic. Yeah. More damage, sure. You just, I don't care anymore. I do care about this though. Probably, like, she gets booted from battle, doesn't get experience. desperation move when you die, apparently. It sucks. MP max up. Cooling that? I don't care about that. Double SP. His special equipment. Oh, and no one's in reserve. That means that Cook and Mac are with Sarah and Kime.
Okay.
In the other party. That's not the worst party.
The family party.
I guess. The family.
The family party and then, like, the fuckwad party. I don't know.
There's two fuckwads here. Set and Jansen.
Yeah.
And Tolton.
And Tolton. Wait, no. Because, like, Sed and Seth are pirate buddies.
Yeah.
And then Seth and Ming are immortal buddies. So it's, like, those three and then there's two,
like,
assholes.
Sed is, like, a teenager. Tolton is an idiot. Jansen is a bigger idiot. And Ming is a queen. And Seth is an immortal badass. Who's a pirate. But this means that no one can really heal without sacrificing MP.
You could give magic to Seth. She knows it.
Does she have any skills I don't care about?
Well, I don't know. She's got level 2 black white right now. You could probably up that to, like, level higher. Like,
level 6. She just knows it. I think Ming is kind of an idiot, but she's a queen. She gets a pass on that. I think being a queen for 1,000 years makes you automatically not an idiot.
Also having to delete your own mind.
Makes her what?
More susceptible to being stupid.
Okay.
I mean, she had to delete her own mind in order to whatever it was.
Yeah, level 6 black body. Don't care about that. Level 2 composite, I can do. Not much. Just leave that, and that's it.
Do you need, like, a thingy for her to do 3, or?
I just haven't found the thing yet, yeah.
Huh. That sucks.
Smart,
Well, Seth died.
Oh no.
So I was up till 6 for no good reason, watching random late night clips. But I found the clip where it's the episode where they have Jeff be an actual sidekick rather than a robot.
Yeah.
Like they give him a voice and stuff. And they have this segment where he talks about, oh yeah, I got a place in New Orleans, you know, with their beads and stuff.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh yeah, I got a place in Scotland. What do you do in Scotland? Him throw beads and stuff.
You found that episode too.
I found that episode.
It was a good episode.
And
hey, I got a place down there.
He had a different voice. Or no, that's the new voice, yeah. Or like the second voice.
The second voice.
Because now it's just like,
now it's more like
just a guy.
Actual sidekick voice.
Yeah.
I think he was tired of doing, like, the Jeff voice and just decided to do his own voice.
Remember the original voice, though?
The ha ha ha, Craig!
Right, Craig!
That's cold as ice!